Hello guys, my name is Mike. Welcome to physics. Now for today, I'll be taking you through thermal expansion. Now we'll be discussing thermal expansion in math. As we have already discussed before that, matter is made up of tiny particles that is always in constant random motion. Now when matter is heated, the particles gain kinetic energy, and when they gain kinetic energy, they move further apart, which means they expand in size or in volume. Now, I'll give an example in solid. So we have a metal ball which passes through the loop or the hole before it gains the kinetic energy. And after it has gained kinetic energy, the ball isn't able to pass through the hole. This is because now the ball has expanded because of kinetic energy. The particles are moving further apart. Now in solid, we've seen that in this flask, what happens is that when the flask gains the kinetic energy, it expands, which means the water level is going to decrease. But after some time, when the kinetic energy is being transferred to the liquid, the liquid then rises back to a bit further or on top of its original state. Now, before we can explain the application of expansion, we're going to talk where we mostly use expansion in physics. Now, also we use expansion most of the time in thermostat. These are liquid in glass measuring instruments, or we use them in bimetallic strip. Now, I'm going to talk about the bimetallic strip. So the bimetallic strip is use of two strips. These are two metals that are riveted together. Now, the first metal might be in aluminium, and the second one might be copper, as I've stated in this example. Now, what happens is that when you apply heat to this bimetallic strip, the aluminium will expand much farther, or the particles will gain more kinetic energy and will expand further or much greater than copper. Hence, the bimetallic strip will bend outwards, whereas the aluminium stripe. Now, the use of bimetallic strip. So the bimetallic strip, because of its characteristics, is used in alarms, and fire alarms rather, and it's used in electric iron. Now, what happens when you adjust your iron at home, when you are ironing your clothes, is that by the time you adjust, we are actually separating the distance between the bimetallic strip and the circuit, which means you are separating the contact between the bimetallic strip and the other end of the circuit. So when the bimetallic strip is much closer, is much closer to the circuit, it's able to break the circuit easily. But when it's further away from the circuit will take longer. Hence, your iron will take longer heating your clothes. Welcome back to the second section of thermal expansion. In this second section, we're going to discuss the consequences or the precaution of thermal expansion. The first example is going to be on power and telephone lines. Now, when telephones or power lines are constructed, there is an allowance that is left for expansion, that is left for contraction. During summer, the cables will obtain expand, which means when they gain the kinetic energy, they'll expand in length, but during winter or at night or during the night, they'll contract. So they are going to hang in such a way that they will allow this expansion or contraction to take place without damaging the power lines or the telephone lines. Now, the second example is going to be on bridge. Now, bridge, when they are being built, the foundation is not entirely made of concrete only, but in between the concrete, there is a rubber that is placed there to allow contraction and expansion to take place. Because when it expands or when it contracts, and there is no that allowance for it to expand, there's likely going to be cracks that will develop over time, and the bridge will collapse. The third example is used in railway lines. So in railway lines, in the old days, they used to leave gaps in between, so that when there's expansion or contraction, there's that allowance felt there's that space for expansion and for contraction, and to not cause any exit in railway lines. Now, this in modern days, there is what is called tapered overlap. Now, the metals, they do not leave space, but they overlap on top of each other. This allows them, or this allows smooth cruising for trains and smooth journey for the passengers in the train. Unlike in the old days, when they used to use the gap in between to allow for expansion and contraction. Now, before we close, or before I go, guys, there's something that I was supposed to tell you in the beginning of the video. We must know that gas, they expand more than liquid, and liquid expand more than solid. So the expansion goes from gas, liquid, then solid. Then gas, they expand more than liquid. Liquid expands more than gas. Thank you, guys. That was it for today.